I am inside of a Jupyter notebook, and I have a list of texts that I would like to analyze. In particular, these are tweets from people who are talking to the support desk of a retailer, and some of these tweets are complaints about food that they bought earlier. So in this particular case, we are dealing with a complaint, and in particular, it is about a lasagna that they bought. Now, if I pretended that I actually worked at this retailer, one of the things that I might be interested in is just doing a little bit of an analysis on the products that people bought and that they perhaps complained about. So the question is, can we build ourselves a system that can find these substrings that describe a purchased item? One way to go about it is to go for the machine learning approach. Maybe we can build a machine learning pipeline that can detect all of these items for us. And that's an approach that could work. You could try to build your own named entity recognition tool, but as a starting point, it might not be the most pragmatic thing. And the reason is that we have these pre-trained spaCy pipelines at our disposal, and these come with some tools that can help detect linguistic features, which in turn allow us to build a rule-based system that might be able to detect these items as well. And in this video, I would like to show you how you might be able to do that. So, as a motivating example, let's say that we have the sentence, I bought a lasagna. Then we can use spaCy to fetch some interesting properties out of that sentence. There are multiple tokens in that document that I can loop over. And each of these tokens also comes with some parsed properties, like, for example, the part of speech. A part of speech can tell us whether or not a token is a verb or perhaps a noun. And that's pretty useful information, but there's also some extra information that spaCy can give us, one of which is the lemma of a token. Now, a lemma is going to be quite convenient for us here because the lemma is going to be constant even if there is a different conjugation of the verb happening. For example, if I were to change this to I buy a lasagna, then the lemma is the same. Or if I say he buys a lasagna, then in that case, the lemma is also the same. So for every conjugation of the verb, I still have this one constant that I can match on, which is nice. And if I then start thinking about all the verbs that might be of interest, to buy is interesting, but you can also use a synonym. So I purchased. And also here, we're going to have a single lemma also for every conjugation of the verb. And this is going to allow me to write a little function that can help filter out interesting texts for me. Here, I have a function called keep that is going to loop over every single token in a document. And if any of those tokens have a lemma that is either buy or purchase, then I'm likely dealing with a verb that's either some form of buying or some form of purchasing, which probably means that we're talking about a product that someone bought. And if I just have a look at some of the examples that I get when I use this filter, then here I have an example where someone is talking about sausages that they purchased. And here I have the example that I mentioned earlier where someone's talking about a lasagna. So this seems like a pretty okay way to detect whether or not the sentence is about someone who bought something. So that feels like a pretty good first step. Next up, though, we might be able to do a similar trick that allows us to fetch a substring that tells us what product it is that they bought. So let's dive into some more properties that spaCy can detect for us. And I'll make a slight difference to the example that we had, because now I am purchasing a veggie lasagna. Now, what I would like to do is just render this document using the spaCy, because when I do that, then I can also inspect some other properties that have been parsed. So note, we still have all of our tokens here. Each token also has a part of speech that's mentioned here below as well. But we can now also see some of these grammatical dependencies that have been parsed. And this can be useful information because if we know that a person is buying something, then this might be able to tell us what it is that they're buying. In this case, though, I wouldn't just be interested in this lasagna token. What I'm more interested in is this entire chunk. The thinking here is that there might be different types of lasagnas, so I do want to capture the entire chunk. Now, spaCy is able to detect these noun chunks for us, but let's now start thinking about how we might be able to combine this with the grammatical dependencies. A noun chunk will have one arc going in, which is going to come in at the root of the noun chunk. So in this case, lasagna would be the root in the noun chunk. But that arc also comes from somewhere. And in this case, we could say that the head of that dependency comes from this purchased verb over here. And here you can start thinking of another rule that can help us, because now we might be able to say, grab a noun chunk, and if the root of the noun chunk has a head that's a verb that describes that something is being purchased, then the noun chunk might be a product that they bought. So in order to explore the code that might be able to run the logic that we're interested in, I am now exploring the noun chunks that spaCy is able to detect. So I have my familiar example over here, and if I look at all the separate chunks that spaCy has found, then the first chunk is I, that's this part, and the second chunk is a veggie lasagna, which is this second part over here. Just like a token, a chunk also comes with some parsed properties. And in particular, I'm checking out the root as well as the grammatical dependency of the root and as well as the head token of that root. And just to reiterate, we currently know that there is some sort of a noun chunk, and we also know that inside of that noun chunk, there is a root token, so to say. That means that there is an arc coming in into that one token. It is from another token that we are referring to as the head token. And here's where we could start thinking about some rules that we might be able to apply. Because we could say, well, if this token over here, if that is a token that has a lemma that indicates that we are buying something or that we are purchasing something, and if we know that the grammatical relationship that this arc represents is something that we are interested in, then this noun chunk over here might just be a purchased product. And if I were to look at the example above, then I can confirm that if we use these rules, that this noun chunk would not be detected as a purchased product, but the second one, that would be. So let's turn this into a proper function now. And there we go. Here is a function called relevant chunk that loops over all the different noun chunks. I am checking the lemma of the head of the root of the noun chunk, if that's either indicating that we're buying or purchasing. I'm also checking the arc coming into that node, if that has the right grammatical dependency type that I'm interested in. And this function on its own can then start yielding chunks that I might be interested in. So what I can now do is I can build a generator that's going to loop over all of my texts, and I can check what kind of products it detects. It detects a lasagna, some curon mints, some muesli, milk, and sometimes I get a token that I'm maybe not that much interested in. But I will say, as a starting point, this is a pretty convenient way to detect chunks that I might be interested in. And I also think that in general, this tactic of using linguistic features to find patterns that you're interested in tends to be quite powerful and definitely deserves to be considered. I do want to mention that this approach is not perfect. There might be some other ways that you could describe that you bought something that doesn't necessarily fit this set of rules. So if you're doing this in practice, you are likely going to iterate on this approach. It's also good to know that some of these parsed properties that spaCy detects are based on statistical models, and these might make a mistake now and again. And if they do, your rule-based system might not work as well as you might hope. But in general, I do think it deserves mentioning that this is also a very convenient way to get started with your NLP project. Another thing that you can consider is that you might have a rule-based system next to a machine learning system, and you might want to run both in production such that you can compare. The main summary, though, is that these linguistic features are very powerful in general.